Birdie. Here you go, little fella. Want some bread, little guy? A little bread for you, a little for you, a bit for you, a little bit for you. Oh, no! Looks like a broken wing. Let's get you inside, little guy. I'll fix you up.
Sweetie, breakfast is almost ready.
Coming, dear. Look, Norma, I found another hurt bird.
Oh, Daryl, not again.
What? Nothing should be in pain.
Okay, sweetie, but hurry up. Your breakfast is going to get cold.
Okay, dear.
Hey, Daryl?
Yes, dear?
When do you think we'll get approved for the birthing?
Oh, very soon, I'm sure. We filled out all the paperwork, went through all the necessary steps. These things just take time.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, how great it would be to have a child, Daryl! How I would love to raise a child in heaven!
There you go, little guy. Now you just sit tight. It'll take a couple days for you to heal.
Can we have a boy? I would really love a boy.
Oh, a boy would be wonderful. I'll get it.
Good morning. Is this the home of Citizen Daryl and Citizen Norma?
Yes, sirree.
The two of you have been living in heaven for 20 years now, correct?
Yes, sir.
Well, congratulations, sir. Today is your lucky day. Your application for one child soul has been approved. So if you and your wife would like to join me, we have prepared a vehicle to go to the birthing center right now.
It's the messenger. He's come for us. Norma, today's the day we get to give birth.
Oh my God, Daryl! We're getting our child! Our child! Our child! This is great! This is wonderful! Daryl, I love you so much.
I love you too. And you're gonna be a great mother.
It is now the time to start the birthing process. Are you ready, Citizen Norma?
I am.
Have you chosen a name for him yet?
Yes. We wish to call him Marius. Little Marius.
Do you two solemnly swear to raise Marius in accordance with the text that Cain has provided us?
Yes, sir.
Do you promise to keep Marius away from the wall and the evil one that dwells behind it?
Yes, sir.
It is your job to raise your child up right here in heaven, so that when God gets back, which should be any day now, he can look in the eyes of our newest citizens and know that they are ready to love him unconditionally. Then let us all thank Cain together.
Thank you.
This is your home now. You live here with us. We're what's called parents. We'll care for you, love you, and teach you all about heaven until you become a man of your own and meet a woman and fall in love. And then, when you're married for a while, you'll get put on a list for a child soul of your own. Look, sweetie, he's taking a liking to Cain already.
That's our savior, Cain. He watches over us and keeps us safe from the fiends that want to come back into heaven but aren't allowed. If it wasn't for him, none of us would be able to exist right now. He deserves all our love, all our praise, and all our thanks.
Come now, don't overwhelm the boy. He's gonna learn all that in the education center tomorrow. I'll bet you're hungry, little guy.
You see, Marius, you just put the fork into the food, like so, and then you lift it up into your mouth and chew. Then swallow. Do you understand?
No. No, dear. You have to speak to him louder. Marius! Put the fork! No, the fork! Into your hand! Hand! Your hand, see? You have two of them, look! This is your bedroom. This is where you'll sleep when it gets dark.
Sleeping is a time when we close our eyes and rest for a while. Cain says we need to rest our eyes for a few hours a night because too much exposure to God's love can wear on the brain. It needs time to rest. We love you, Marius, and we are so happy you're here. Okay, son, this is it. This is where you'll be spending a great deal of time until you get used to things. You'll learn everything you need to know to become a functioning member of our society. It may seem a little overwhelming at first, but it will help everything make more sense. I promise.
Please take your seats. My name is Mr. Apple. I'll be your teacher for the next few years. Now, if you turn your information packets to page 3, we will begin our lesson for today.
name's Marius. What's yours?
Eden.
Well, what you looking at?
The wall. Don't you wonder what's behind it?
The evil one and all her lies dwell behind that wall. Our Lord Cain built the wall to keep her out forever. You see, Cain and the evil one were once a team. They built and founded heaven together. But our humble Lord Cain just couldn't tolerate her deceitful ways anymore. She wanted to use and exploit us. So Cain did what he had to do. He did it for us. He cast her out, that filth, so that we may live here in peace. Let us all thank Cain.
Recovery. Marius! Come here, son. Okay, son. Put him down. Look at him fly! You see, son, all life in heaven is equal. One creature is not more important than the other. We're all alive, and therefore, we're all loved by God. And God's love is unconditional. So if you see one of God's creatures in danger, it's your duty to help it. Then, someday, it might help you back. Do you understand what I mean, Marius?
Well, gee willikers, Mr. Dantine, are you sure it's safe to be carrying this child so close to the wall while holding a sign that says, "I don't love you, Cain"?
Sometimes you just gotta walk on the wild side, little Johnny. Cain ain't the boss of me. I'm my own man. In fact, I'm thinking of maybe even eating meat on Fridays and slapping my wife in the mouth.
Wow.
Now, Mr. Dantine, say it ain't so. Don't denounce Cain. Don't.
To come into your homes and corrupt your youth. And there's nothing any of you can do about it.
Oh my God, what have I done? If only I could turn back time. If only I could accept the love Cain for the perfect, non-flawed individual that he is.
Stop right there, you fiend.
Destroy this place! I will have my way with all the children!
You will do no such thing! I cast you back to the place from which you came!
No, Cain, no! I love you! And everything is my fault! You are so much better than me at everything! And better looking than me, too! Please take me back, Cainy Pie! Please!
Goodbye! Bitch.
Well, thank you ever so kindly, Mr. Cain. I will hereby love you forever and do whatever you say.
Ladies and gentlemen, do not take pity on her. You will find that
Once the Evil One's minions have all been purged from our society, that heaven will be a much brighter and better place.
Let's go! the area. Make sure nothing came through. Shit, boss! Where did this all come from? Get this all sealed up before anyone sees it. Kill anything that tries to come through. Get that, boss!
They say when you go into it, you fall directly into her hand. And then she carries you back to your home, where she makes you murder all your pets. One by one. Well, Marius and Eden, how nice of you to join us.
Sorry, Mr. Apple, I'm not as good as you, I never will be.
Mr. Apple, I was just wondering, can animals talk?
Just take your seat now.
Does that mean yes or no?
Felt right. But when the kitty spoke to me, I don't know, I felt something different. Do you feel it?
What?
They are special. Wait, I'll eat some first.
Thank you.
the garden.
How did you get in here?
A long time ago, God was a misfit. He chose to keep to himself, and he lived alone in the universe. He created beautiful, radiant stars, circled by tiny rocks made of twigs and water. But they were all vacant, and without any life. He was lonely. He wanted to create something new.
Broken. It is like the wind made him
everything else must be destroyed. I am without him, and now I am nothing. I wandered the universe alone, searching and searching, and never finding anything. I didn't look at the creature the way God looked. I wasn't upset that it wasn't as smart as me. I felt honored to teach it a companion that would be with me forever and always looked up to me because I came before it. I discovered love. I became infatuated with them. The way they moved, the way they looked, the things they did. Oh, the noises they made. But I made some mistakes, and after each mistake, they became more terrified of me, until all of a sudden, they forgot who I was. And they wanted nothing more to do with me. God doesn't love me. He doesn't love me. And they don't understand. I am alone.
Kids more comfortable. Believing that synthetic misrepresentation of flesh of your soul. Watch and do what I do. Thank you. the light, penetrating every dripping opening on my soul, sending shivering bits of life up and down the chain of my
in you, son. How many times have I told you to not accidentally fall out of your window in the middle of the night and get into some late-night romantic adventure with the girl down the street that involves you outrunning the Oswald Evil Prevention Squad? There was an attack by the Evil One's minions a little while ago. Don't you know we're at an evil alert level magenta, blue, green, circle, square, star?
Thank you, boys, so much for bringing our pride and joy home.
You could have woke the neighbors up. His lawn is already greener than mine. This is all I need.
He was the runt of the litter. The messenger warned us he'd be a little bit off. Would you like a cookie, dear?
Sidekai, man. He's a good boy. Just gave him a light from the windows until he learns how to sleep a little bit better.
Oh, you bet we will. Son, no windows for a month. No, that's not fair. All right, how about a week? We can board them up together like father and son.
We better get going. Keep that little shit under control. If I ever catch him anywhere near the wall again, I will be forced to use excessive brutal force. You hear me?
Of course. Thanks again, officers. Here, I'll see you out.
Oh, Marius, I'm so happy you're home. I love you so much. that it's the middle of the night and it's way past your bedtime, mister.
No, I mean about...
Hey, you're not disobeying your mother, are you? Get to bed, young man. You have a long day of nailing your windows shut tomorrow.
But Dad!
Move it, Buster.
Remind him that you love him.
I love you, son.
Tell him that he's special.
You're a special boy, Marius. You think I was too hard on him?
No, you're a great father.
Mm-hmm.
tastes like dreams. Your life is meaningless.
Terrible! But you know something? I think Kane can speak to us through that little dead bird. You wanna know why?
Why?
Because Kane knows every time a little tiny baby bird dies and falls to the ground. But he leaves it there to show us how much he loves us and how much the evil one hates us.
You see, Marius? You see what happens when you leave the house?
We all do, Lollipop. Hey, watch out! Don't let those ants bite. Kane provided us with those ants so they can eat the dead things, and we won't have to look at their ugly corpses all over the place.
I'm
on
the destiny
grapple
on my way to church.
Exactly, Lollipop. So you see, Kane thought of everything.
What happened? Norma! Norma, what are you doing? Marius, don't look!
Why? What's going on, Dad?
Don't look! Cover your eyes! You don't understand, Marius. Couples, they don't see each other without their clothes on.
What? Why?
It's one of the rules. Jeez, what are they teaching you in these schools?
But we can't just let her suffer in there, Dad.
It's heaven, son. There's no suffering in heaven.
It's Mom! We have to do something!
How about some ice cream? Is it good?
I don't know, Dad. I'm not exactly in the mood for ice cream right now.
Oh, sure you are. It's always a good time for ice cream. Ice cream, you scream, we all scream for ice cream. Seriously, though, don't ever scream unless you're really in danger. Otherwise, people are not gonna believe you.
Can we at least check on Mom?
Hun, do you have any clothes on yet?
Daryl, help me!
We better wait a little while. She sounds like she's in a mood right now. At you. All better?
Good sir, could you possibly spare some bread for a bird down on his luck?
Marius? That wasn't funny.
Hey! Down here! Take a look down, good man.
You can talk?
Of course I can. Didn't they teach you anything in school, sir?
No. Well, I mean, maybe I...
Hey, relax, no big deal. Maybe they just forgot. I mean, they forgot to teach your son about the thing with the naked ladies. Your wife is in the other room giving birth to something rather fierce. You should really get in there and help her.
But Bird, I can't go in there while her squidly pie is out.
I'm sure that under the circumstances, you'd be forgiven for your trespasses.
Can you just maybe go in there and make sure the evil one isn't in there?
You have my word, good sir. There is no one of evil descent currently occupying your living room. Just the beauty and magic of childbirth. Do go inside and see. Go on.
Please.
Fine then. I'll play along. Wait here. Yes, sir. Everything seems to be in order here.
Son, I want you to get out of here and get help. I know. It doesn't matter. We have to help your mother. So go.
All right. I love you, Dad.
I love you too, son.
So clearly, King is telling us that as long as you stay here with him, you'll never, ever die.
Help me, please! Please, I need somebody's help! My mom is naked, and my dad is talking to birds! Help me, please! Help, help,
Kate,
please, anybody!
Kate, I
want somebody
to thank
help
you for
me.
Being there for me when no one else was. You helped me go on. You saved me from the darkness. You saved me from drowning in the darkness.
He's like the slug that's going over the razor's blade with his slime, but he's doing it with angel spit, brah. Oh, man, dude. He's got it figured out. I seen him once. Not really, but you know what? He comes to me at night. He gives me good ideas. He tells me, go preach my word, brother, and I'll look out for you.
Drink or a cool towel or something?
Daryl, I spoke to God.
Oh, yeah?
He's not coming back.
What? Did he say why? It wasn't something I said, was it?
He's not coming back because this isn't heaven. And I have a demon inside of me.
A demon?
Daryl, please get it out of me. Get it out of me.
Okay.
Tail King.
Something for me. Your wife is a very special lady, and she is carrying something of great value, but it's too heavy for me to carry on my own. Can you bring it somewhere for me?
What are you talking about?
Please, good sir, you've always helped us birds in the past.
What is it?
It's a surprise.
What do I do?
Go into the kitchen, get yourself a knife, a great big sharp shiny one. How about one of those new ones you ordered the other day from that magazine? Oh yes, the one that had the neat video where they cut the tin cans in half, yeah?
Well, now what do I do?
Oh, yeah, take it into the living room. Take off all your clothes. You don't want to get her sticky juices on them now, do you? After all, cleanliness is next to godliness. Yeah, you want to look good when God comes back, don't you? Hey? Lay down next to her and hold her in your arms, yes.
Don't worry, sweetie. The talking bird says it's gonna be okay.
Comfy, isn't it? Go on now, don't be bashful. Rub against her a little, at least a bit, until you feel the tingling. That's God's way of rewarding you for a life well lived. That's love, Daryl, that's love. Yes?
This feels nice.
As I bet it does. Why, my good sir, it even looks as though you are glowing. Not a shy one, I see. She's like putty in your hands. Now you've got her wrapped around your little finger. She trusts you completely. You can raise that knife up and make an opening for that abomination to rip its way into this world. Try to rip it out.
Oh,
Quick, don't let it escape. Chase after it.
I love you, Norma. I'll be back soon, I promise.
It's Kane.
The sounds that come out of your mouth.
I could just lay here and talk to you all night long.
I feel so safe with you. Like nothing bad could ever happen. Oh. Why are the others afraid of me?
Well, that's because you're different. They don't understand you the way that I do.
The fruit. Maybe that's the answer. Can you help me get the others to eat?
How can you say no to those eyes?
Oh, you're beautiful. Nothing compares your beauty in anything in the universe.
Yes. Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Oh,
yes.
Gorgeous.
It is. Oh, yeah. I know. Oh, you're too. Thank you. You're too kind. Oh.
I don't like it when the other ones eat your fruit.
What do you mean?
It just doesn't make me feel very good.
That's not fair to everyone else.
If that is what I have,
it would be selfish not to share.
And suddenly I don't feel so special anymore.
Thinking about you. I'm glad I finally gotten you alone. I need you. I can't get your very image from inside my brain. Such wondrous curves, those luscious lips with your forests of long, tangly orange hair and that piercing way that you look deep inside my eyes. It's as if you can see all the way into my soul. You just drive me insane. You bring something out of me and give me this weird, tickling itch. But no matter how hard I scratch, I just can't soothe it. It's becoming swollen. Please, just touch it for me, please.
What? Get off of me.
I would do anything for you. I would slice apart the tallest mountain, behead the beast of your choosing. I would even walk on water if it prevented you from drowning. Now how about we get to know each other a little better?
The others only project the colors that you have already seen.
God, you? Isn't it really you?
Of it all, I lost my fucking place in the fucking story.
Sorry, sir.
Go over the wall and get him.
Are you sure?
You heard me. Put on your little helmet and climb into the big boy seat of that great big fucking tank I got you and wipe him off of the face of this planet. You got that, you dumb fuck?
Sir, yes, sir.
Where am I?
You're waking up out of your dream.
Where's that breathing coming from?
Your lungs, Daryl.
Where's Marius? Where's Norma?
Don't worry about them. They're both fine. Probably gathered around the telly watching their pop on the evening news, helping out his birdie friends. Wonderful human interest story, don't you think? Huh?
There seem to be a lot of animals out here tonight. Don't you think?
Just ignore them and keep moving.
Why are they watching me?
Because they hate you and they want to taste your stringy flesh.
I don't like the way its eyes are looking at me.
Just shut up, will you? You're too stupid for this conversation. Just keep moving.
I want to be its friend.
don't know. I don't know how to communicate with it. Why did he do this? Why would he put all of us in the same place and not let us talk to each other?
Look, you disgusting waste of flesh. The only way I can get out of here is through God's door. But I need him to open it first. Now you're either going to help me do that, or my friends are going to hold you down and I'm going to peck the fucking eyes out of your big stupid skull. Now do you understand what I'm saying, or should I cleverly word it into a sitcom script so that your feeble little brain can process it easier? Huh?
I don't feel so good. Everything looks so weird.
Do you think you're the first man to travel down this path of enlightenment? You think you're something special?
If you were rotting on the side of the road, I wouldn't even stop to eat your face meat.
From your side and slaughter them one by one.
Leave me alone! Stop!
Kill them, Darryl.
Kill them, Darryl. Chew them.
Meat of their bones. Taste their souls. Stop! Leave me alone! Leave me alone!
Darryl, stop crying. Darryl, stop crying. Calm down. Don't cry, Darryl. Darryl, stop crying. Stop crying,
Darryl. I just
want
to talk to the animals. Like we're equal.
Come on, Darryl. Gah, we're here. Come on, Darryl. Get up. We're here. Now you can talk to any animal you want, I promise. Just open your eyes.
Okay. Okay. What are you?
Please, that beast on the altar.
What?
I said, place the creature on the altar.
Tell me who you are.
We are the remnants of an ancient people who chose the path of the life giver instead of the sky monster.
What do you want from me?
You hold in your hands the only creature to ever be born from a virgin skin. In her eyes, it's the most beautiful thing ever created. I want you to rip its guts out and dangle them in front of her fucking face.
Never!
She must be about it for what she's done. Every second must be lived.
no way out. It's best you just do what she says. Just be happy you met her before the other one. Otherwise, you might have ended up like me.
I said kill it!
Come on, Daryl, do it. Plunge that blade straight through its heart. It killed your wife, remember? What do you care? It's not of your seed anyway.
Look at its eyes. They're so bright. Full of life. There's a soul in there!
Shut your fucking mouth and do what I say!
Almighty King, please open the skies so that I may receive your light. Please open your heart so that I may receive your love.
What are you doing?
Please open your home so that I will never be alone.
Shut up right now.
I love you, the Almighty King.
Stop right now.
Should I ever find myself lost in the shadow of the beast, then grant me the ability to see through the darkness and find your path again.
Shut up,
Almighty King.
Shut up.
Open the sky so that I may receive your light. Please open your heart so that I may receive your
heart.
Please open your home so that I will never be alone. For I love you, the Almighty King. And should I ever find myself lost in the shadow of the beast, then grant me the ability to see through the darkness and find your path again.
Pull you up. Don't be afraid. Ain't is here.
As soon as they discover me, they try to worm their way back inside of me, but I won't let them. Then it drives them crazy.
Ooh.
waiting for me with open arms. He didn't want me back. He wanted me to stay bound so I couldn't flow towards him ever again. I will lay here with my eyes closed tightly, drifting in and out of consciousness, where I will dream of laying beside him as he whispers forgiveness in my ear, praying that this world he created for me will still be here.
Thank you. Obey your parents and the law, for this is right, that you may longer live and enjoy a better life. Almighty Cain, lover of my soul, built this perfect place, staring into the sun, blinded by your beautiful face. Amen. Hail Cain. Praise Cain. Praise Cain. Amen. Yes, children, yes. My folk, we are gathered here today for the most joyous occasion of all. An occasion where we bring a new child's soul from the previous world into heaven. Give praise to our Lord. Give praise to our Savior, Cain. Citizen Daryl and Citizen Norma, please step forward. The time has come for the two of you to walk the path of glory and choose the worm baby that will grow into the child you so desire in your hearts. Follow me.
Praise be to Cain!
Wow, he really said it all! No sugarcoating or bull malarkey at all. What did you think, son?
I don't get it. What did the evil one do?
What do you mean?
What did she do to make her so evil? It must have been bad.
She lied. A lot.
Lying is very bad, son.
What did she lie about?
Well, I mean, there was that time where she... You know what I'm talking about, Daryl? That one time when...
You know, I think I know exactly what you're talking about. The time with the coins, right?
Yes, yes. The time with the coins.
Great. Well, now that that's settled, what do you say we hit the hay?
Good night, son. I love you.
Cover your ears, son. Don't listen to it. It'll be over in a minute.
Don't listen to its lies. Don't let it speak to you. What was that sound? Why is everything shaking? Who wants breakfast?
Oh, I do! Me!
But wait, what was that? What was that sound? Guys, wait! Did anybody else hear that? Where are you going? Breakfast? For forgiveness.
You see, son, she wants to come back to heaven so badly that she sits outside our walls and screams. Sometimes all day.
And do you know what we do when she screams?
We close our eyes.
Close our ears.
We do.
Then off to school with you.
You know you're only going to be able to do this so many times.
Bread! Bread! Who wants some bread? Bread? Bread! Who wants some bread?
Hey, Dad! Have you ever noticed that heaven has a lot of birds? So what's up with that?
Really? You think so? Guess I never really noticed.
This is all just so confusing. I wish you could explain it to me better.
I mean, are you even sure God's coming back?
Well, yes, son. Haven't you been listening? Canis told us that God should be back any day now.
Daddy's been singing for months now!
Easy come, easy go.
Hey, Dad. One more thing. Can animals talk?
Did you say something, son?
No. Oh, you came back for me.
Yes, just stay still. We're going to rescue you.
No, wait. Don't touch me. No, leave. It's a threat to leave one out. Please get it off me.
Okay, Marys. Grab a side, and on the count of three, we both pull, okay? One, two, three.
What the fuck are you doing at your house after curfew?
Please don't shoot, don't shoot, please don't shoot, please, please. I was in my room and I fell out of my window. Because my window's right next to my bed, and when I fell, I hit my head on the ground. Oh God, where am I? I don't even know where I am. I'm just so scared right now, guys. I'm just so scared. I don't even know if I'm alive, guys. Please, I didn't mean to do anything. I just want to
die. What the hell are you doing, man? Don't point your gun at a kid. He just fell out of his window.
Like I really should have kid. Okay.
How did you manage to fall out of here anyway, son?
Oh, you know, just one of those things.
Well, how'd you get so far from the house?
I rolled.
Rolled?
Yeah, I don't know, Dad. I guess. Why are you bugging me? I guess we live on a hill or something. I just rolled, okay? Jeez.
You know, I was just telling your mother the other day that our block felt a little steep. I'm gonna bring this up at the next block association meeting. You mark my words. My son can't even sleep in his bedroom at night without ending up in the park.
Dad, don't you get weirded out with these birds around constantly? I feel like they're watching me.
You know, I think you're developing an unhealthy obsession with these birds, son. They're God's creatures,
Dad,
just like
yeah,
you
great,
and me.
Great, Dad. Dad, great.
Just
great,
relax.
Dad.
Yeah, when Dad. God comes back yes. in a few days, everything will
great.
Be different.
Great, Dad. Yes, yeah, great.
You know we're boarding up your windows for your own good, right? It's not because we don't love you.
Whatever.
All right, y'all. We've reached the end of the road. From this point on, there will be no more tricks, no more special effects, loud noises, or misleading imagery. That part is over. But this is the most important part of your journey. This is not a scare tactic or some guilt trip we're trying to lay on you. As you saw in the film, some people ascended to heaven with Kane, while the others were left on the ground to burn beneath his feet. If God were really to return tonight, do you know where you would go? And do you really know, or do you think that you do? You are taking a chance on your soul for eternity. Kane needs soldiers for his army. We need to fight the evil one every way we can. Whether it's joining the Oswald Evil Protection Squad or teaching your children the dangers of asking too many questions, so they do not end up like the kids you saw in the film tonight. And also so you don't end up like their parents. So what y'all gonna do? Are you gonna stay on this side of the wall, protect our way of life? Or are you gonna venture to the other side and become a black-winged demon or mutated animal slave? The choice is up to you. Can I get a Hail Kane? Can I get a Hail Kane? Can I get a Hail Kane?
Hey, big guy, you have any dreams? Shucks. Well, don't you worry about it. You will soon, I promise.
Dentine, are you sure it's safe to be carrying this child so close to the wall while holding a sign that says, I don't love you, Kane?
Sometimes you just gotta walk on the wild side, little Johnny. Besides, Kane ain't the boss of me. I'm my old man. In fact, I'm thinking of maybe even eating meat on Fridays and slapping my wife in the mouth.
Now, Mr. Dentine, say it ain't so. Don't denounce Kane. Don't do it. Please don't do it.
Citizen Dentine, hereby denounce our Lord and Savior Kane. I want to be the evil one's bitch now.
I am the evil one. I want to come into your homes and corrupt your youth. I want to steal your pets and eat all your disgusting worm souls, and there's nothing any of you can do about it.
Oh my God, what have I done? I've doomed us both. If only I could turn back time. If only I could accept and love Cain for the perfect, non-flawed individual that he is!
Stop right there, you fiend!
Holy fucking shit, it's Cain!
You! I'm here to destroy this place! I will have my way with all the children!
You will do no such thing! I cast you back to the place from which you came.
No, Cain, no! I love you, and everything is my fault, and not yours. You are so much better than me at everything, and better looking than me, too. Please take me back, Cainy Pie, please.
Goodbye, bitch.
Well, thank you ever so kindly, Mr. Cain. I will hereby love you forever and do whatever you say.
Yes, yes, that's great. Ladies and gentlemen, do not take pity on her. You will find that once the evil one's minions have all been purged from our society, heaven will be a much brighter and better place.
Well, gee willikers, Mr. Cain, why are you just so fucking great?
Didn't I tell ya? Didn't I tell ya? Oh, I told ya. Oh, I told every single one of you. Who is the man? Who is the motherfucking man? I am the motherfucking man. I am the main motherfucker. I'm the motherfucking man. I am the motherfucking man. I told you.
Hello.